So now I'm going to talk about what I call the crux of leadership. And this is whatever you do and think you are and want to be as a leader, you start off with looking in the mirror, okay? Because it's not fully binary, but many of us have a certain level of thoughts and bias about our fellow man, right? So if you look in the mirror and you say, what is my general belief of my fellow man? And if my general belief is, they're out for themselves, they're rascals, they'll just do what they want to do, and you know that's what I think about my fellow man. Versus, I actually think there are some turkeys out there, but most of them basically want to do the right thing. They want to actually understand what the good things are to do, and they want to do the right thing. It's a pretty important understanding, because what happens is you can manage both ways and be successful. And if you don't trust people, what do? You try to manipulate them. You try to fool them. You try to force them. You try to lie to them. But they're not going to do the right thing anyway, so you've got to find some way to twist them into doing things your way. By the way, that works. Doesn't create the kind of culture I want to work in, but you can do things that way, and you see it done all the time. Manipulate people, force them, fool them, etc. The other side is, it's a little slower. You got to actually start out by listening to people. And so that's where this value descent and challenge cynicism. I had a man read the Dr. Crisis, and he was a CEO of a Fortune 100 company. He said, I wish I had read that 25 years ago, because I used to just assume that all the angry guys were just mean and mad at me. And he says, I went back and replayed some of my big crises when I was at Visa. And he said, some of these guys were exactly right, but I overreacted to their energy. So value descent is, some of these people, they're still negative. They're still going to come at you with some very energetic disagreement, but they have some forward-thinking solutions and some ideas. They care enough to hang in there with you, even if they're passionate. Whereas the cynics will sit on the sidelines with arms folded and declare that today, once again, the place sucks, and it always has sucked. It still sucks, and by the way, you suck. Cynics will suck the marrow out of your bones. And so do not spend 80% of your time trying to cheer them up. Challenge them. Try to convert them into dissenters by saying, give me something I can deal with. Turn that into some sort of positive request, even if it's something I know that I can't do right now. Let's start talking together. This is that sort of sharing. And so this is leadership in one slide. Listen, acknowledge, challenge, and repeat. We talked about partial credibility versus full credibility. But this notion of the person with a very different point of view, high level of energy, big dissenter. I had one of my great mentors, a guy named Bill Marsh, who used to say, one of the things you got to remember is when somebody is acting so unreasonable in your frame of reference that you don't understand them, just remember that. You don't understand them. Your job is to understand their frame of reference. Because while a certain percentage are just turkeys, but that's a small percentage. Most of them have enough data and information that from their point of view, it's valid. What they say makes sense to them. So this is the idea of listening. And this is not listening. The worst part of listening is, okay, I'm going to listen to you for 10 minutes, then I'm going to pour out my message. You know, I'm going to give you 10 minutes, and then I'm going to just blare out my message, because that's why I'm really here. This is a process that's very iterative. Listen and acknowledge. Okay, I hear that, but wait a minute. I understand that, but what about, we also have this problem. So I acknowledge you, but I'm also challenging, because I'm adding this. This is an iterative process of sharing context and joint learning. And it takes the rank out of rank and the rancor out of a lot of conversations. It's a little slow at first, but you start to build relationships with people you trust and trust you. And I'll tell you, this is a marvelous thing in the long run. It's just that you have to have the patience to believe in it at the beginning.